What's up, my baby loves? I'm PokeCinema, and we are back for some more Pokemon Platinum version. In the last episode, we took on Iron Island, and now in this episode, we're going to take on the Canalave Gym Leader. He's a Steel-type Gym Leader, so we're going to be able to easily take this guy out with Infernape and Octopussy and all of our Pokemon. It really feels weird saying Octopussy, I'm not going to lie. One of you guys said that I missed one of these trainers, but, you know, I don't recall missing any of them, but whatever. And I got a text message. Sorry about that. I've been getting a lot of... What are you doing? A lot of interruptions lately. Yeah, I get interrupted a ton. Something you guys should know. But anyway, sorry for the lack of uploads. They should be regularly continued or whatever. Very soon. Like, I should be able to upload once a day now. I'm really sorry about not uploading a ton. It's, I was gone and I've been busy. Just had a ton of stuff on my plate lately, so I'm really sorry about that. But let's go ahead and continue on these platforms to try to make our way to the gym leader right up here. You know what? Let's go this way. I hope that we haven't... Okay, there's nothing over here. I'm trying to find this trainer that some guy said that I missed last time, just trying to make sure that I got everybody. Did I fight you? Okay, I did. Well, let's check over here to see that I didn't miss anybody. All right, didn't miss anybody over here. But yeah, like I said, I've been really busy lately. It sucks. Most of my day is spent going to school and then coming back, doing homework, and then I practice, so I've been really busy lately. So sorry about that. But uploads should be continuing a lot sooner, a lot bananas. I don't even know what I'm talking about. But yeah, I find time to record. I can. I have time at night when I can record. But anyway, here's the gym leader, so let's go ahead and save right here really quick before we fight him. I know he's going to be pretty difficult. Like I said, he's a Steel-type gym leader, so it's kind of odd. The only other Steel-type gym leader that I know of is Jasmine, but let's go ahead and lead out with Octopus. No, you know what? Let's lead out with Rick, just to be safe, because Rick is our strongest Pokemon. All right, let's go. Let's see what you got.
Ah, that's Orberg's gym badge. I see. You've defeated my son. But that's no surprise. He still has much to learn. In place of my son, Rourke, I... And Byron.
Byron, and my phone is still vibrating.
Byron, will take your challenge.
Yeah, okay. Alright, that's great. No super speeding. The bio should be popping up right now about his Pokemon and what he has. I personally do not know what he has. I'm going into this completely blind. Alright, looks like leading out with Rick was a really good idea. We should be able to take this Magneton out pretty darn easily. Let's go with a close combat because it's still stab because we are firefighting type, so let's go ahead and use that. And this should be able to KO this thing if I am correct. Alright, yes. I hope this thing doesn't have static. I don't quite recall its ability, but its ability will be in the bios, I guess. Like, I don't know. I go into these battles blind, but you guys get to see all this cool stuff. You know what? Let's stay in. I think that we can take this thing out with a close combat. If we can't, then we're dead, but who cares? I'm pretty sure we can... pull this thing out with Octopussy. But here we go, let's go for that close combat and hopefully take out the Steelix. I really am confident that we should be able to. No! No! Oh god, that Steelix is gonna destroy us unless it uses... Nope, it used Earthquake. Alright, looks like we're dead. Pretty sure that should kill Infernape anyway with two defense drops and two... Yeah, we're dead. There's no way we can live. And if we do, I'm really, really gonna be surprised. Okay, I knew that was happening. Don't worry, guys. I still got this. Let's go out with Octopussy, I guess. Just because it has some good stats and Surf should be able to take this thing out, if I'm correct. If it doesn't heal, okay, he healed, so that's pretty bad for us. Two Surfs should be able to take this thing down, if I'm thinking correctly. Come on, do good damage. Okay, that did really good damage. I didn't expect it to kill it. Alright, well there's Steelix dead and gone. Alright, now his next Pokemon is going to be a Bastiodon. Let's go ahead and stay in and just see how much Surf does. If we do have a problem, I'm confident that we can revive Infernape and just go for a Mach Punch, so it shouldn't be too much trouble. Let's just go for that Surf. Hopefully it does over half. If it does over half, I'm pretty sure we're good, because I don't think this thing will be able to KO us in one hit. Wow, one hit KO. We got a critical hit. Awesome. Amazing. Take the thing out, no problem. That's the sixth gym badge right there. Good game, hater. You suck, Byron. My sturdy Pokemon seem to suck balls. Yes, they do, my friend.
you were strong enough to take down my prized team of Pokemon. In recognition of that power, I give you this, the Mind Badge. Cinema, the Mind Badge from Byron.
Yeah, that's my way of celebrating, I guess. Alright, thanks, dude. Now you have 6 badges. That means that all Pokemon up to level 70 will obey you without question. Here, take this too. It's probably like, I don't even know. I don't know. I'm not going to pretend to know. Flash Cannon. Ooh, that's pretty good if you have a good steel type to use it. Like, that would be good for a Magneton or a, can't even remember the thing's evolved form. Where am I going? Am I going this way? Yeah, this way. I hope this is the right way. Okay, it is. Alright, we did it. Yay! Defeated that guy, we got our 6th gym badge, and now we still have a lot of time left. Oh, look, it's Barry.
Hi, that's my badge. Good thing you're tough enough to consider becoming the Pokemon champ. Of course, I'm tougher, so it's not gonna actually happen. Derp. Anyway, Cinema, come with me to the library.
You know what? I gotta heal my Pokemon before that, dude, because they are pretty hurt. So let's go ahead and go to the Pokemon Center and heal up our Pokemon. That was a good battle, you know, I like that gym, but it's not too challenging, because steel just has so many weaknesses, plus most of the time it's like, ground as well, you know what I mean? Not dissing it, because I know people are like, steel type's the best, you know, there's gotta be some people like that. I'm just saying, it could be better, could be a little bit better, but let's go ahead and lead out with Stefani, because we need Stefani to gain some more levels. Alright, well, let's go see what Luke wanted us to do.
Too slow, goo! Come on, let's move it. Derp.
Okay, let's go. I'm pretty sure that the professor and the whore Dawn is gonna be here. So let's go ahead and come up here, see what's going on with these guys.
Hey, Cinema, over here, this way, derp, good poop.
Okay, good poop. He totally said those words. I'll look at it pan over.
Okay, Gramps, I brought Cinema like I said. Alright, I'll be out of here.
Okay, I get it.
Everyone's finally here, Cinema. Everyone, listen. You may have forgotten already, but I studied the evolution of Pokemon.
Oh, really? You do? That's great.
But the more I study, the more mysteries appear and multiply. Pokemon that evolve and those that don't. What makes them different from each other? Those that are immature as living beings evolve to ones more mature? If so, what do we make of the legendary Pokemon that don't evolve? Are we to assume the legendary Pokemon are complete as creatures? This is where you three come in. In the Three Lakes of Sinnoh, there are said to be Mirage Pokemon. If we can obtain data on them, it may shed some light on how the process of Pokemon evolution works. I need help from each one of you on this grand of the balls. Okay, you know what? I'm tired of all the dialogue. Basically, he wants us to go check out these lakes because there's stuff going down here, and that'll also lead into further parts in the story. I don't really want to spoil anything, but I'm pretty sure everyone's played this game.
Dawn, you go to Lake Verity.
Will do. Okay, I got more text messages. Hey guys, stop text messaging me, okay?
Yeah, of course, Gramps, I'm good in the pants.
Come on, man. Okay, I'm super speeding this. I'm sorry, guys. I know what to do. This is just, oh, what was that? Has it stopped? Are all of you unharmed?
What was that about? No, wait, I mean, TV, the TV, news, everything.
Okay, here we go. Now we finally get to go into the story. It looks like they blew something up, and by they, I mean Team Galactic. Please, go faster, I see.
What you have just witnessed is actual footage from the scene. It was taken from a cameraman who happened to be there. It's certainly impressive.
Okay, so it looks like they blew something up at the lake, and we gotta go find it. You know, I am very impatient. I don't really like all of the stuff. I don't know what I'm trying to say. I don't know what lake I'm supposed to go to. Maybe I should have listened to that. Actually, I think I do. I go to the one by Jubilife, if I recall. Well, here, we'll see. The tremor was a real... Oh, hey, old dude's kids, did you hear? They're saying there was a huge explosion at Lake Valor. I heard everything's fine now, but I'm just guessing it's a lot of noise. Gramps! I'm going, I got a bad feeling about this. Okay, he's going to Lake Valor. And that Luke can't sit still. Cinema, Okay, I'm going to Lake Valor. Okay, I'm confused. You guys, just shut up. Let me do my thing. Yes, okay. Now we can finally freaking fly. If you guys watch any of my older videos, you know that I hate, and I mean hate, dialogue. It's kind of annoying. I don't hate dialogue, but I don't know. After you play a game so many times and know the dialogue, it gets kind of annoying. Is this where I'm supposed to go? I'm trying to... Oh, right here, derp, with all the water. Yeah, Valor Lakefront. Yeah, okay. Okay, sorry about that. Let's go ahead and fly there. And see what's going on, see what that explosion was all about. Apparently, things blowing up isn't very good. So, I'm gonna have to explore that. I actually liked this part in the game, though. Originally, I thought it was so cool, but... With Black 2 and White 2, it really blew Platinum out of the water, in my opinion. On cutscenes, anyway. On cutscenes. Platinum was pretty cool, but... Man, when you play Black 2 and you play, like... You just get really into it. Same with Black and White. Like, the cutscenes are much better. Not the gameplay. Not saying that they're better games. Just saying that the cutscenes... And they really draw you in. You know what? Let's go get that item. I don't want to leave an item sitting there. Dang it. Stupid Pokemon and you're appearing out of nowhere. Ooh, you know what? I kind of want to kill you. Just for your EXP. So, thank you. Good game, hater. You're done. Alright, right up here, though. I want to get this item. See what it is. It better be something useful. Okay, a big root. I don't know what that does. Off the top of my head, I'm pretty sure it heals you. Maybe. I don't even care. I know someone's gonna explain it in the comments, so whatever. And they're probably gonna rage at me like, Cinema, you noob! You have to know everything, you're PokeCinema. Hey, you know what? I don't study Pokemon. Hey, an item. I swear I've already gotten these items. I don't know how they're appearing. And an Ultra Ball, sweet. Got it for free, bro. Alright, well now we can finally gain access to this place. And like it said on TV, there's a huge explosion, so you can see the lake is completely gone and dried up. Alright, dude.
Ha ha ha, next stop, Lake Verity. The closest civilization is that hick-down Twin Leaf.
Wow, what a douchebag. You don't call people hicks, unless they live in, like, the south, like me. Would you like to join the Magikarp banana raid? No, I wouldn't. I don't know what this person's talking about. Okay, let's go for a Magical Leaf. Hopefully it'll take this thing out. Not quite. Come on, one more Magical Leaf, and that is good game. This is Kitty Cat. Murkrow. You know what? Let's just body slam this thing. Hopefully we can get it paralyzed or something. It doesn't matter. Got that thing killed, and we're level 40. Nice. Overwhelming. Yes, it is. I know. I'm the best. I'm so good at this. Let's switch out to Octopussy, get this thing leveled up really quickly, because Octopussy is probably the best guy on our team right now. Hey, whoa, look at all those Magikarp. Holy crap. That'd be something if there was like a Gyarados, a red Gyarados here, just kind of like an Easter egg or something, like really far off in the corner. I think it'd be cool. I would think it was funny. We set off the Galactic Bomb, blah, blah, blah. Okay, congratulations, man. I know. Let's Aurora Beam this thing, see how much that does. Ooh, almost KO'd it. Okay, one more Aurora Beam, and that is good game. We are level 41 as well, so that's nice. Growing levels like a boss. You know what, guys? I think we're going to have to continue this on in the next episode, because it looks like we're running out of time. So thank you all for watching. If you haven't already, you guys should click the link below to my Twitter page. It's where I update you guys on basically what's happening. So if you would like to stay updated with what's going on and why I might not be uploading something or anything like that, you should go ahead and click the link below. But anyway, guys, thank you all for watching. I will see you guys next time.